All right, and so here we go with another circuit in our playground workout series. We're gonna kick this one off with some lat pull downs. Again, a playground's a great area. They've got all these overhead, solid, rigid bars. And so for a lat pull down, pick one above your head. I want you to go through full range of motion with this. Lots of people cheat and don't go quite as high and quite as low as they should. And so you're up here, you're just gonna pull up and then come back down. Again, working through as full range of motion as you can. You're gonna rep out 10 of those. Now, I realize that a lot of people can't do a full lat pull down, and so what I've suggested, especially to my wife and sisters-in-law, everybody who I've suggested this type of a workout to, you can come over and you can actually cheat it a little bit. You can do more of a negative lat pull down. And so you're right here, what you're gonna do is you're gonna actually jump up to the top of it and then slowly lower yourself down, okay? So that's a little bit easier. The easiest thing to do is gonna be to come right over to, again, some type of stair, ladder, whatever they've got at your playground available. Go ahead and grab the bar up here. Now your legs are supported. Don't hit your head on the bar. Your legs are supported as you're pulling up and down to do those lat pull downs. You're gonna do a set of 10 of those, then we'll go on to the next exercise. So our next exercise is gonna be a triceps exercise, one of my favorite. It's called dips. What you're gonna do is find a surface. I've got a couple of bars here that are just a little bit wider than shoulder width. If you come into this position with your knees bent, you can come down into the dip and then use your triceps to extend back up straight. Just like that is what a dip looks like. If that's a little aggressive, again, that's kind of a full body weight exercise. You can minimize that by doing more of a tricep extension or a seated dip. And so to do that, what I'm gonna do is come into this position. Again, now all of a sudden my legs are supported. As I come down and push up, that's what my dip looks like. Again, at a little bit less intensity. Rep out 10 of those and then we'll move on to our next exercise. And for the next exercise, I call it a pike. I've heard it called seated crunches. Basically, what you're gonna do is you're gonna find a place to sit down with your legs straight out in front of you. And as you recline back, what you're gonna do is you're gonna use those muscles in your abdomen, your ab muscles. You're gonna bring your legs up and your chest up to your knees. So it looks just like that right there. Okay. And so for this one, again, you're gonna do 10 of these. And then we'll move on to our next exercise. We're gonna do some lunges. And so we're gonna finish this circuit out with some lunges. Okay, I mean, really simple. You're gonna get one leg way out in front, the other leg way back behind. You're gonna lunge straight down. Lunges, I don't want you to lunge forward with your body. I want you to get into this position. I want you to drop straight up and down. Try to keep your knee right over your toe. If a straight lunge is too easy, what you can do is make it more difficult by incorporating, well, in the clinic, we call it a balance lunge. You're gonna kick one leg up on a surface behind you that's a little bit higher. Try to maintain your balance. And then in this position, this is where we're gonna do the lunge. Just like that. Makes it a little more difficult as this down leg has to work a little harder to stabilize you. Nice job, you finished another circuit.